Welcome to my channel. This is the next session in control system. Let's see some MCQs in the control system. Right? The question number one is, using Routes criterion, the number of roots in the right half is plane for the characteristic equation. The characteristic equation given is s power 4 plus s2s cube plus 2s square plus 3s plus 6, which is equal to 0. The options are option A 1, B 2, C 3, and D is 4. And how do we find the roots lie in the right half of this plane? By the Routes criterion table, right? So I have formed the Routes array by starting from the s power 4 and ending to the lowest order s power 0. In the s power 4 term, I have filled the rows using the characteristic equation. The s power 4, I have filled 1, 2 and 6, even order terms. And s cube, 2, 3 and 0. And the next term is s square. I obtained the s square value from cross multiplying the 2 into 2, 2 into 2 minus 1 into 3 divided by this particular term. This term is nothing but 2. I obtained the value was 0.5. And next, for the next term, since this is the 0, you without any multiplication, you just simply put the upper term as 6 for the next term. And s power 1. For s power 1, I have cross multiplied the 0.5 into 3 minus 6 into 2 divided by the particular term. 0.5. Obtained the value was minus 21 and the next term was 0. Right? And since this term is 0, I can able to put the upper value for the s power 0 term. I have put the value was 6. Okay? And our question is, what number of roots lie in the right half of the S plane? So far we have discussed about the left half of the S plane. And now we are supposed to find out the right half of the S plane. Right? In this, first we need to check the number of roots in the left half of the S plane. Right? How do we check the number of roots in the S of the left half of the S plane? By the means of stability check. The stability check is in the column terms, if there is no sign change. So see here, from 1 to 2, there is no change in 2 to 0.5, there is no sign change, and 0.5 to minus 21. In this case, there is one sign change, and minus 21 to 6, if there is one sign change. So the sign change values are considered as the number of roots in the left half of the S plane. In LHS, I have two roots. Right? And I need to find out the RHS side. RHS side, I obtain it, substitute the order of the equation. Order of equation minus the LHS side. So, order of the equation here is 4th order. The higher order term is 4th order. And higher order term 4 minus the number of roots in the left half of the S plane. S of the left half of the S plane is obtained by the sign change. Right? 0.5 to minus 21, there is one sign change. Minus 21 to 6, there is one sign change. So, 4 minus 2, I get the value was 2. The number of roots lie in the right half of the S plane is 2. The option is option number B. So, either it may be on left half of the S plane or it may be on right half of the S plane. You can expect one particular MCQ in the question. Just kind of outside question. So, next question. Next is question number 2. In the question number 2, you are supposed to find out the feedback control. Question 2 is the feedback control system represented by the open loop transfer function.
the given as g of s h of s is the open loop transfer function. Check this g of s h of s is an option A is this unstable system, B is the stable system, or is the marginally stable system, D is the insufficient data, right? So open loop system is converted into a closed loop system by the formula 1 plus g of s h of s is equal to 0. So I have substituted the g of s h of s value as 1 plus 10 into s plus 2 divided by s plus 1, s plus 3, s minus 5. And I obtain the equation as s cube minus s square by cross multiplying this. Right, I obtain the equation as s cube minus s square minus 17 is minus 15 plus 10 is plus 20. And the characteristic equation for the closed loop system is s cube minus s square minus 7 is plus 5, which is equal to 0. Once again, by the means of Routh's stability check, I have supposed to find out whether the system is stable, unstable, or marginally stable, right? Well, I have filled the data by this characteristic equation for the s for higher order, s cube higher order term, and the s square the next term. And I have cross multiplied these values. That means 1 minus 1 into 7, minus 1 into minus 7, minus 5 into 1 divided by minus 1. And I obtain the value was minus 2. And for the next term, it is 0. Since the next term, this term is 0, I can able to put the upper term in the s power 0 without any multiplication. Or you just check this, you get the same value. Minus 2 into 5 minus 1, which is equal to 5. You are able to get the same upper value without any multiplication. You can just replace the upper value for the s power 0 term, right? And our question is, well, check whether it is unstable, unstable, or marginally stable. And by the means of Routh's criterion, how do we check the system is stable? By the means of the first column elements without any sign change. Here, check from 1 to minus 1, it is, or the s cube to s square term, there is a sign change. And minus 1 to minus 2, there is no sign change. And the, once again, there is a sign change as minus 2 to a 5. So, and positive value, negative value, negative value, and another positive value. Due to this, there is, we come to say this, the system is unstable. So, answer A is the correct answer. For the open loop system, we obtain the third order the characteristic equation. And for the third order characteristic equation, if we undergo for Routh's criterion check, the system is unstable. So we say the system is unstable as by the first column elements sign change. And next question. Question number 3. The question 3 is, the feedback system shown in figure is stable for all values of k is given by. Already we have discussed an open loop system. Here this is the closed loop system, right? The output is once again fed back to the error amplifier. And the options are, option A is k greater than 0, k less than 0, and C is 0 less than k less than 42, D is 0 less than k less than 60, right? Once again, I used to check the stability and the k value by the means of Routh's criterion. And for finding the value of k, once again, I frame the Routh's criteria. And when the array is formed by the formula for the closed loop system, this is according to the rule number 3. And block diagram reduction, rule number 3. We obtain the equation 1 plus g of s by g of s into h of s. I substitute, then I get the characteristic equation as s cube plus 7 s square plus 6 s plus k, which is equal to 0. And for the stability check, I fill the values from S cube. This is the higher order term, from S cube to S square, right? And S cube is, I know, 1 and 6. Since it's the odd order term, I put the odd order values. And next term is the even order. I fill the even order terms, so 7 and k. And next higher order term is S power 1 and minus 42. I obtain the value by cross multiplying 7 into 6 minus k divided by 7. Right? And since this value is 0, I just put the value of k. Right? Here, we are not supposed to find out any number of roots lying in the LHS side or the any roots lying in the RHS side. Or we are only supposed to find the k value in the given closed loop transfer function. The k value can be obtained by the S power 1 term equation. We get the S power 1 term equation as 42 minus k divided by 7 is greater than 0. Why I mentioned this is the greater than 0? Since the system is stable system and there is no sign change and the values obtained are greater than 0, I am writing the equation as greater than 0. And equating towards 0, 42 minus k by 7 equal to 0. If this is equal to 0, I obtain the value 0 less than k less than 42. The answer is option C. Right? So, remember, write the characteristic equation as 42 minus k divided by 0 greater than 0. If the values are greater than 0, we obtain the values as less than 0, and the less than 0 value is 0 less than k less than 42. So, the questions today we have discussed is the repeated questions in the many cases of examinations. In the case of TRB, TNB, CT, etc., you can expect such kind of questions for your examinations. So, if you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.